Did you know that if you reach your account storage limits in Google Drive, you won't be able to send or receive emails? That's because your storage is shared across Google Drive, Gmail, and Google Photos. In other words, Gmail and Google Photos all count towards your overall Google Drive storage. So, if you're working with a free Google account, you've got about 15 gigabytes of Google Drive storage, and you might be nearing capacity. So, this is how to quickly clear Google Drive storage. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and so much Google content, you'd think I work for them. I could only wish. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to free up Google Drive storage. There are a couple of ways to do this and it's easier than you think. So let's go. So first, let's go over how to see what's using up your Google Drive storage and how to clear files from Google Drive. From Google Drive, if you click on storage on the left, you'll get a snapshot of the files using your drive storage. And that's really great and all because you can get a quick glimpse of all the big stuff here and you can quickly select those files to delete them right from here. But we want to get even more niche than that and see what's using up the most space. So you can click on buy storage. Don't worry, this won't buy anything right away. And actually, before I click off here, I want to point out I've got more than 15 gigabytes because I've already upgraded. So you can just kind of ignore that there. Now, if you click on buy storage, you will be taken to a drive storage page that might look something like this if you have this link to a domain, where you'll get a snapshot of the overall storage used. But if you click on view details, here is where you can get a breakdown of what's taking up the most space. But if your account is not linked to a domain, your storage page is going to look a bit different. So when you click on buy storage, you're going to be taken to Google One, and this can be accessed by one.google.com and then click on storage. Now, a perk about Google One is that they have a quick access link on the storage page, so you can click on free up account storage and you're going to be taken right to a storage management page where you can quickly free up space from Gmail, Drive, and Photos. So it'll tell you discarded items and how much space that's taking up. It'll tell you large items and how much space you can free up. And then there's an other items section as well. So that's a really quick way to free up Google Drive storage via Google One. But if you really want to dig around further, we can do the same things manually and luckily for us, still quickly. So let's start with clearing Gmail space. Rather than spending hours and hours clicking through all your old emails from oldest to newest, or even searching for specific senders and deleting content that way, there are a few quicker ways to free up space. The first thing I like to do is take a quick peek at the other tabs, the social tab and the promotions tab. Typically, these can be bulk deleted unless, of course, it's something important like a shipping confirmation that you need to keep. But bulk deleting is really easy. You can just click the select all toggle at the top and then hit delete. Next, check out your spam folder. Google does a really good job of flagging spam, so you can bulk delete here as well if you like. But the real winner for gaining space in Gmail is found in your search bar. You really want to quickly find big files, the ones that are taking up all the space. So in the search bar, simply type has:attachment, and that's all one word, there's no spaces, space, larger:, and then we could say 25 megabytes or whatever size it is that you want. Gmail doesn't let you send files larger than 25 megabytes, so I find that's a good place to start. You can of course narrow down that search by using 10 megabytes instead if you wanted. This will easily allow you to find all the emails with large attachments. So once you've found the emails, you can delete, select them with the toggle box to the left, or bulk delete using the main toggle above those. And remember, you have to empty your trash once you're done deleting your emails from Gmail. So Gmail holds deleted emails for 30 days in your trash before clearing it. So if you need that space right now, empty it out using the empty trash now option. So now let's talk about how to clear Google Photos storage if you really just want to dive into photos and you don't care so much about the other stuff. If you use Google Photos a lot, that can be taking up a ton of Google Drive storage too. So you can just head to photos.google.com and again, click on storage on the left. Now here you're gonna get an estimate of how long it's gonna take you to run out of storage, which is super helpful, but you'll also have a quick section here of items to review and delete. Now these include large files, blurry photos, screenshots, and more. So if you wanna quickly review your large photos and videos, you can just click on that and then select which ones you'd like to delete. So this is similar to how you do it in one fell swoop in Google One, but here you can get more granular. And remember to delete your photos from the trash once you've cleared out that space. This is actually crucial because Google Photos keeps trash photos for 60 days before deleting them forever. So remember at the top, we went to our Google Drive storage and we got a quick list of the files that are using up the most space. So let's head back there for a second for an extra quick tip or two. From your Google Drive, so that's drive.google.com, we're in our little storage section here, but I just want to point out that you can also pop on over to the shared with me section. And from here, it may be helpful for you to organize the files based on share date in order to sort them from oldest to newest. So you just click on this arrow to the right of the share date option to reverse the order. Now you're gonna have the oldest ones first. So you can just like shift select a whole whack of files from here if you don't need them anymore. And just like everything else, remember to empty out your trash when you're all done because any deleted files will be held for 30 days. And another thing to keep in mind, a lot of this can be done on mobile too. So if you want a snapshot of your storage, you can just do that right from the Google Drive app. So tap on the hamburger menu and then tap on storage. Here you're gonna get a snapshot, and if you click on the view details, you can see what's using up the most space. But if you wanna clear Google Drive storage on mobile, go ahead and download the Google One app. And then in the Home tab, select the option to clean up account storage, and you're gonna be able to follow those same steps we did from desktop at the beginning of the video. It's really that easy. I know. So that's how to quickly clear Google Drive storage. May you run free in all your available space. And now I want to hear from you. Have you run out of Google Drive storage? What do you think of these tips? Let everyone know in the comments below. And as always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for more Google content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.